I was reading something about Ethan Page, how he got the phone call. He said he was on his on a layover, on his way to an independent show, and somebody called him and said, you know, it was WWE, and they wanted to offer him a contract. And he was like, you know, he thought it was somebody kidding. He thought they were playing, you know. And, he's like, yeah, yeah, I'll take it, you know, whatnot. Whatever they offered him, he said he'll take it. He hung up, went to the independent show, and then he got home. And they had called him and told him, you know, about the contract. And he goes, was that, wait a minute, that phone call was real? And then, boom, he's in the company. Just like that, not really thinking about it. But just let you know, something I talk about all the time as far as your name. If you're good, and the radar is on you, your name will get there before you do. I really believe that. And I feel like a guy like Ethan Page, he fits perfectly in the NXT system, even though he's been in the business for 17 years. He doesn't look weathered. He doesn't look like a guy that's been, you know, overused or anything like that. I think perhaps maybe the time in AEW may have helped him just because it gave him some exposure. Because before that, Ethan Page being in the business 17 years, I didn't know him.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? But once he got, got my eye on him, and then next thing you know, boom, I was like, man, who is this guy? I mean, it was just something about it. I was like, who is this guy? Not really ever thinking or imagining he would be in NXT or, you know, in a WWE system. But I'm going to tell you, he fits in perfectly from my eye.
Well, I will say this, because you said when you saw him in AEW, you thought, hey, this is a guy who's got talent. Maybe he could be something. Maybe he could do something. When I saw him in AEW, this is just me being 100% honest, I didn't think that there was anything that stood out to me, right? He seemed like another guy on the roster. And this is a perfect example of when you have an idea for somebody and you put that quote-unquote push around them and present them in a certain way, all of a sudden, you, as an audience member, I look at them differently. Like, if you go back to ECW, if Taz was on the WWF or WCW roster at the time, would have never given him a second look. It's just a guy.
I don't know. Right? I don't know, man.
Oh, no, hold on. Let me finish. But the way that ECW presented him as the Samoan, you know, submission machine, or not, I'm sorry, that's Samoa Joe. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What was his name? What was his moniker?
He was the submission machine. I can't remember. We'll think of it.
He came out with the towel. The aura around Taz made him feel like such a bigger deal by the way that he was presented. And when I see Ethan Page, the way he's presented it in NXT, to me, it's almost a 180 from what I saw with him in AEW. AEW is in a faction. He kind of talked, but he was kind of on the sidelines. He was with Scorpio Sky. They gave Scorpio Sky the strap. Ethan Page was never really positioned as somebody who
He never was.
But 6 weeks, I don't question him as the NXT champion. That's what a presentation can do. With the right look, the right human suplex machine. Thank you, Eddie Kane, Maine. I knew I was close. With the right presentation, somebody can become a star very quickly and be legitimate within the fans' eyes.
I'm going to tell you right now, a lot of it is the music.
Music helps.
That music, man. I'm going to tell you, bro. I'm bought in. I love it.